Feeding the ever-multiplying global population is putting too much pressure on our land, according to the United Nations, who says we have to change our ways. It says agriculture, forestry and other land use accounted for 23% of the total net greenhouse gas emissions caused by humans from 2007 to 2016. The UN's Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or the IPCC as it's known, has been meeting in Geneva to discuss ways to relieve the pressure.
We humans affect more than 70% of ice-free land. A quarter of this land is degraded. The way we produce food and what we eat contributes to the loss of natural ecosystems and declining biodiversity. When land is degraded, it reduces the soil's ability to take up carbon, and this exacerbates climate change.
The IPCC says vast reforestation programs can't be relied upon to offset environmental damage because such plans would take too much land out of food production and could endanger food security. Instead, it suggests making farming practices more sustainable by growing different grasses for animals to graze on, rearing different breeds of livestock, and seeking genetic improvements in stock. And it had a message about our diets.
Diets that are high in grains, nuts and vegetables have a lower carbon footprint than those that are high in meat, and they lead to better health outcomes.
There was also a plea to stop wasting the food we do have.
25 to 30% of food produced is lost or wasted. And reducing food loss and waste can reduce pressure on land, improve food security, and reduce greenhouse gas emissions.
The report didn't specifically mention the Amazon rainforest, which stores 127 billion tonnes of carbon. That's despite a new report from Brazil's Institute for Space Research saying deforestation in the region has increased by 279% over the past year. But the IPCC did highlight the need to preserve and restore forests. The overall message was while land management alone can't save the world from the most devastating effects of climate change, it could play a role in limiting the damage. Sarah Morice, TRT World.
For more on this story, let's bring in Dan Osborn. He's a professor of human ecology at University College London, specialising in environmental policies and strategies. Welcome to Money Talks, Dan. Now, the IPCC's far-reaching report specifically looked at the relationship between land use and the climate crisis. Tell us more about what it found.
I think you've covered quite a lot of the key points that are in the report in your piece beforehand. I think the key messages that the report has got about solutions are really interesting. It talks a lot about local management of land and tailoring the solutions to the circumstances of particular parts of the world. And I think that's really very important in dealing with this particular issue, this part of the climate crisis, as it's now being referred to.
Now, one of the headline findings that really has captured the world's attention is this call to perhaps cut back on our meat consumption. I'm wondering, in your view, how closely linked is food and the climate crisis?
Well, we've got over 20% of the greenhouse gas emissions coming from, if we like, broadly speaking, the food and forestry sector. So we have to do something to change the way we're dealing with food. Reducing waste is one way of doing that, and that would economically be very efficient. But some investment in more sustainable ways of using land, helping ensure that carbon is locked up in the land effectively, those kinds of changes would mean that land would become more of a sink for carbon rather than a source. So we've gradually got to change that kind of balance. And if we act now and don't wait till things become even worse, then it becomes much more affordable to do that.
Now, is there a danger, though, that these findings may shift the focus away from carbon-polluting industries, such as factories or power plants? Does this report let them off the hook in a way?
I don't think so. I think this report is just a particularly focused report looking at one aspect of the climate issue. So there's no way for people to get off the hook here. Factories, etc., transport of various kinds. There are a number of sectors of the economy, energy production itself, for example. All of these things are contributing to the climate issues. So this is just a particularly focused report looking at land use, and it's particularly relevant to those countries where there are lots of opportunities for producing agricultural produce more sustainably.
Okay, Dan Osborn, we'll have to leave it there, but thank you for helping us to unpack that latest report.